Hi guys, this is Super Sam once again, and this time around, this is not how to tutorials, but let's talk animation. So let's talk animation is a series of videos meant to discuss animated projects. Okay, we've had about three episodes before now, but then I had to stop because I was busy with other projects, so I didn't have enough time to continue Let's Talk Animation. Until lately, I get messages from different people asking questions on how to do one or two things based on their animated projects. And so I thought it's a good idea to bring this into Let's Talk Animation so we can talk about the projects one after the other. So if you also have your own projects that you want to share with me, or you want to ask one or two questions about how to do about some stuff, you can easily send me an email, or you just hit me up on Facebook or something, or you can also drop your intentions in the comment section below. So last month I got a mail from Rodrigo. He shared a video reference with me talking about how to animate a hand holding another finger. Okay, so he wants to know how you can animate your hand holding the finger of the other hand. So I promised him that I was going to do a video on how to do that. And for a few weeks, I've been unable to do it because I was so busy working on other stuff. And finally, I had the time to do it, I think 2 days ago. So this video will be about how you can do that, but I want you to see beyond animating a hand holding a finger. I want you to see tips that you can use to create contact in your animation, because contact is one of the elements in animation that is very, very important. Okay, it makes your shots believable. I don't think you would ever see any tutorial where the coach will tell you how important contact is, but then watch through different animated videos on YouTube, and I can tell you that you see contact, the character making contact at a point or another in that shot, because contact is very important. Okay, for example, you have a bouncing ball animation, right? There is a contact between the ball and the surface where the ball interacts with. That is contact. Imagine a bouncing ball without a platform where the ball interacts with. It's going to look off. Okay, so that's how important contact is. Another example is if you have a shot where the character walks into the scene and then says one or two things and leaves, that shot wouldn't be as interesting as a shot where a character walks in and then interacts with objects around him, maybe leaning on the table or hitting the cup on the table, off the table, or just doing something very funny. Okay, so just try and include contact in your shots. Anytime you try to animate something, make sure your character interacts. So today I'm going to show you how you can make your finger, okay, interact with the other one. Remember, contact, very important. So one thing I want you to know is, before you can do this, you need to understand the physics behind every action you want to animate, because it's very important. Okay, you can't just get your reference and go to your system and start animating frame by frame or something, or trying to do what they call rotoscoping. It just doesn't make sense. You need to understand the physics behind every action before you animate them. So now we're talking about animating contacts using one hand to hold a second finger and moving it around. Okay, now the question you need to ask yourself as an animator is, when I make this movement, what are the key elements that are acting in order to get the right motion that I want? Now the first thing is, you can see you have 1, 2, 3 joints here, and every other finger has that also. Now, when I pull this finger here, the major rotation is coming from the joint here. That means for this animation, this joint is very important. That is one. Then number two, I have the other hand holding onto this finger, right? Now, my thumb is also very important in this animation, and the index finger too on my left hand is also important, because I'm going to grip this other finger using my thumb and the index finger, and then I can make my movements. Okay, now let's come back to animation. In 3D, you have your 3D character. Your character is rigged. Of course, if the character is not rigged, you cannot animate. Anyway, there are several ways you can still animate a character that is not rigged, but for our purpose here, your character has to be rigged. At least that is the industry standard. Okay, so once the character is rigged, you have different joints that can control any part of the finger you want to animate with. Okay, so in your case, Rodrigo, I don't know how you've rigged your character, but I want to suspect that I'm sure your finger would have joints also, so that you can easily curl the finger this way. So if you already have your rig in place, that's perfect. Now the next thing you want to do is make sure you target the joint here responsible for this movement, because it's very important. And once you target the joint here, you're going to add a constraint to that joint. Now this constraint will help you map the finger and attach it to the other hand that needs to drive that. I don't know if that makes sense. Depending on your software, if you're using Blender, for example, you have to use the constraint. And there are two different ways of adding constraints in Blender. You have the object constraint, and you also have the bone constraint. Okay, so because we are dealing with a rig, an amateur here, you need to work with the bone constraint and not the object constraint. Okay, so I'm going to show you quickly how that can be done. So quickly, to do the animation, you need to get your rig ready. And I've also created a selection set for both right and left hand, and a pose library set. If you don't know how to create a pose library set, watch one of our videos on how to create a pose library set. So now, this is what the hands look like. I'm trying to pose in order to make it look good in camera. You can see the camera on the left part of my screen. Just trying to get a very nice silhouette for the hand. And in this case, I'm also going to walk from end point to the beginning, which means that I know that I want the right hand to grip the left index finger. So I'm going to start with the contact first, and then I'm going to key that and probably save it using my pose library, so I can get into that position on the particular frame where I want the contact to take place. So sometimes it's good to walk this way, because it means you wouldn't worry about really posing your character, since you already have the poses saved in your pose library. All you need to worry about is just how to walk your way into that pose and out of that pose. So that's the kind of method I'm going to work with here. And make sure you dedicate enough time for your blocking, because they're very important. Your key poses are very important. They are the storytelling poses. So make sure you invest enough time in it. But I'm going to do this quickly, because this is just a sample to show you how you can go about yours. So I got hold of the wrong control, so I'm going to zoom in and readjust. Okay, and also make sure you tumble around your objects in the 3D scene to make sure everything is working in all angles and not just from the camera view alone. So this is how I want my grip to look like. Yeah, it's looking good in different angles, and it's also looking good from the camera. Now I can see this pose. Okay, so I'm gonna click on this joint here. For the medical students, they call it the metacarpal phalangeal joint. And all I want to do now is to make sure this joint is a child to my thumb. And I'm going to use the bone constraint. So child off. I'm going to target the rig and make sure I target the thumb. That's thumb 3. Okay, just clear and then set inverse. And that gets you back in shape. Now when I move the right hand, you can see it controls the index finger easily. So all I need to keyframe is just the position of the control for the right hand. And my index finger will follow accordingly. And to keyframe that, use the influence. Just keyframe the influence. That would help you animate it. So when the influence is at 0, the index finger will be a child of the thumb. And then when it is at 1, when it's at 0, it won't follow the right hand, but when it's at 1, it's going to follow. So you can see that, just add a new pose library, a new pose to save the pose for the right hand, which is a grip, and for the left hand, which is the index. So now that has been saved. So just go and take out the influence in order to avoid this error and keyframe the influence. So I'm going to bring down the influence to 0, keyframe it and delete these keyframes. Okay. So I want to start from this position and I'm going to go to the frame where I want the contact to happen. And lock down the information there. All I'm doing now is trying to have fun with the animation, just setting keys on the right hand and also setting keys on the left hand, just to make it a bit interesting. And I'm also working my way into the contact pose. You can see that. Okay, just going frame by frame, checking out how the animation flows into the contact pose. And here, you can see I'm trying to go the extreme way, just to drive home the point. Yours might be more subtle than this. And if you don't want your hand to look like rubber, the way mine is looking at now. So you just have to be prudent in moving your controls. You wouldn't necessarily want to go this extreme. Yeah, and at any point in time, you can spend more time to fine tune your poses. I'm doing this fast because it's just an illustration. If I were working on a live project, I'm going to spend more time in trying to block things out this way. I'm just trying to compensate for the movement of the right hand. And don't forget to key your poses so you don't lose your effort. And if you are the kind of person who always forgets to key, I would advise you work with auto keying. Now you can also check out one of the auto tutorials on how to effectively keyframe objects. So this is what you have. You have the right finger gripping the left index finger, the right hand rather, gripping the left index finger. Yeah. So there you have it. That is how you can easily animate a contact using two hands, one hand holding a finger from the other end, and then you can pull it around. In my case, I made it so exaggerated, and then the because of that, you can see the finger looks fluffy, looks like a chewing gum. Okay, so it depends on your own case. So you can be as subtle as you want to. I just had to go the extreme way just to make the analogy make a lot of sense to you guys. If you have any animated shorts you'd like us to talk about, you can send me the information via email or you can drop your comment below. I'm gonna read the comment and then know what exactly you want to talk about. And it would also be helpful to send a video of your short so we can easily talk about it. So thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to our channel if you've not done so. And until next time, keep your creativity blending.